I'm Shivali Patel, a brand evangelist at Helium 10 and an Amazon seller. And I'm here with Robert, who has been thinking about selling on Amazon. And this is now our third video.
Yeah, video number three. So the last one we talked about how to find a great product to sell through product research with Helium 10. But what's this video about?
This video is all about sourcing. So let's say that we found the perfect product, right? After we found those 10 to 20 product opportunities in black box, we narrowed it down and picked one, right? Mm-hmm. So then it's really more about who's going to make that product, how much is it going to cost you, and where is it coming from?
Yeah. And it's good that we're going to find someone to make that perfect product, because I can't make it on my own.
Yeah,
I got enough stuff in my life.
Yeah, and that's okay, you know? So there are many ways to source. You can source locally if that's what you choose to do, but I also recommend Alibaba.
And Alibaba is what?
Alibaba is a platform that connects you to all the manufacturers around the world for all different sorts of products.
Okay, so it's almost like an Amazon where you can search for a manufacturer
exactly.
who makes the products.
Yeah, so the same way that you type something into Amazon to find a product to buy, here you would type in the product into the Alibaba search bar and you would see the search results would basically populate with different suppliers or manufacturers that are making that product or could make it for you.
Oh, neat.
Yeah.
Can we see it for a second?
Yeah, we can. And actually, the information I'm about to share can also be accessed from inside of Helium 10's free Chrome extension.
Oh, yeah. I forgot it was free.
Yeah, exciting. Cool. So let's see here. Okay. This is what Alibaba looks like.
It almost looks like Amazon.
It sort of does, yeah. So let's just type something in. Give me something to type
in. That's coffee mugs.
Coffee mugs. Oh, yeah, let's see. Coffee mug. All right, so as you can see here, there's different sellers that can make that product, and you see that there's a price, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this says for 60 pieces.
Okay.
This one says 100 pieces. But the point here that I'm trying to showcase is there's different sellers that you can go to, and based on the reviews, as you can see, there's 4.7 stars here, 5 stars here with 159 people that have reviewed it, and then different price points. So you can go through that to find possible suppliers you'd be interested in working with.
So how many manufacturers would I try to get by going on Alibaba?
That's really up to you, because it's also really about comfortability and the quality of product you're looking for. So I would say do more than just two or three people, right? Two or three suppliers. But a good range could be somewhere between 10 to 20. And then as you start to really talk to them, you reach out to them once you find, yes, visually speaking, I like how this product looks in the images they've provided. I like, maybe the price point that it's set at, you can reach out and then begin to narrow that down to 3 to 5 suppliers, really, that you stay in communication with to order samples.
Okay. I mean, it looks like it's almost a buyer's market, because there's so many manufacturers, you can choose the best one for you.
Yeah, you really can. And, an important thing to note is also, let's say you had a product that you wanted to improve upon, right? Like you found your perfect product and you say, hey, I kind of want to use it or make it in a different material or use a different set if, let's say, it had hooks or something like that. Then you could ask the suppliers and say, hey, how much would it cost me for this modification? Or would you be willing to work with me on that? And then go from there based on maybe the quality of communication with the supplier. Can you, because sometimes there's a language barrier, right? So you have to keep that in mind. Can they respond with the time difference? Can you communicate with them? Is this somebody you can see yourself building a business with long term? So things like that, as well as the price point, are really important when you're shortlisting those suppliers.
Cool. So then let's say we choose a manufacturer. This person's willing to, talk to me. Do I just place an order for all my units with them?
I would evaluate some samples. So once you've shortlisted, right, down to 3 or 5, like I mentioned, then you want to talk to them about ordering samples. So you can really evaluate that quality of that product before you go all in, right? Because Sometimes it's more high stakes. You've saved for a while and you want to do it right. Especially have a product that you can really stand behind and support and believe in.
Yeah, I guess I wouldn't want to order 1,000 units of something that I haven't tested and held in my hands.
Yeah, and that's a really good point that you make too, because it really doesn't have to be 1,000 units. So if you're watching this and you feel like, I don't necessarily want to get 1,000 units, you don't have to. There are suppliers and manufacturers that sometimes have as low as like 60 pieces or 60 units that they say is like a minimum order quantity.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so you can invest a lot less and still get into business.
Okay, so I find the manufacturer on Alibaba. I get some samples from them. I'm like, this person's great. I want to do long-term business with this person. Then what do I do?
So once you've figured out that supplier that you want to work with, you can start thinking about inventory levels.
Inventory?
Yes.
Okay, how many units to order?
Exactly how much you want to order. So once you figured out how much of the product you want to order, then you have a fun challenge on your hands.
Oh, that sounds fun. What is the challenge?
The challenge is coming up with a name for your product or your brand.
Oh, I get to create my own brand.
Yeah, you do. Isn't it neat to think that somebody out there is going to use your product at some point and then think of your brand name and associate it to what you built?
Yeah, that is. Let me say, what about Robert's brand? Is that all right? I'll keep workshopping it.
That's fine. Keep the creative process going.
Okay. So I create a brand, but then I need a logo too, right?
Yes, you need a logo. And you can choose to create that yourself, or you can also refer to Helium 10's trusted partner directory as well to find a vendor that you really want to work with.
Okay, so I can do it myself or get an expert, and it probably would be a lot better.
Totally up to you.
Okay.
Your call.
So now I know how to source my product using Alibaba, and then how to brand my product and get a nice little logo and all that stuff. So now that's all ready to go. What's next?
So once you figured out what you want to sell and you've sourced that product, then it's really about actually starting to sell on Amazon. So we'll get into that in the next video.
This is the moment.
This is the moment.
Wow.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit like and subscribe and hit the bell to get notified whenever we have new content go live on our channel. See you soon.